I finally made it to JFK, and here's the British Airways terminal. Over here are the entrances for Club World First and Concorde class. Here's the entry to Concorde room at JFK. There it is.
At the risk of repeating the June tape too much, here's the plane I just came in on. I'm very tired. It's 6:30 in the morning.
Now here is an airplane model. This thing's huge. British Airways Concorde. Arrive before you leave. Here's another shot of that great model. And that would happen to be at the entrance to Heathrow. Well, here I am at the aviation viewing area, temporary, set up for departure of Concorde, arrival of Concorde, that kind of stuff. And it's about an hour until the departure of Concorde on one of its tour trips. Apparently this is not the right place to be though. I need to be on the other side of the airport. So I'm going to ride the bus around there. And here are the bleachers that they have set up for viewing of the Concordes. And there's a couple fellas that were giving me good information. I'm on the south side of Heathrow here. Their aviation fans seem to be collecting.
it was later than that when we'd seen some people moving, and then I asked somebody with a radio, and he said, "Oh, it's going off the roof." And the security police, they were slowing me down. And of course, it's a bit of a way to go because the other Concorde was there going to go across. Oh, you know, so I was filming that because they stopped dead long ago. I was filming that as it took off, so I panned from the other one.
There it is, the Concorde. It's going to taxi out to the end of the runway and take off towards us. Some people have found tires to stand on.
Well, he's down, he's gone down. Yeah. Yeah, just perfect.
Concorde taking the runway. Comes. There's a fellow that's got a good vantage point for the landing of Concorde. I, on the other hand. So the plane's gonna come in that direction there, past to my left. I don't really know what kind of a shot I'm gonna get. Probably not a very good one. There. Okay, here comes Concorde, flashing its light. 23rd is finally here. I'm at Heathrow, ready to go inside to get my boarding pass and fly on the final flight of Concorde. Okay, this is Terminal 4, and that's the entrance to the Concorde ticketing area. I'll be headed in there to get my boarding pass, and then on to the plane. Ticket counter for Concorde at Heathrow. I've checked in and I'm ready to head to the Concorde room. This is the British Airways Lounge Pavilion entry.
So people are working tomorrow and trying that, then you're like, man is going to do it me and saying that something that you're saying is all being up.
Do you go somewhere for BA or something?
No, I do travel a lot with them, mate. That's company, so.
Well, that'll be it then. I think, just so you remember, I think I've probably got the last one.
Yeah, because a couple over there.
Long
list. Yeah, I like that. I'm guessing the line card is quite long.
flown a lot with the old work, so.
Thank you.
Down there.
Yeah.
I've been spotted.
Just a little bit. For your information, gate 25 is approximately 15 minutes walk from this lounge.
Almost as many people on the ramp as in the lounge.
Unbelievable.
It's more than a Concorde. No, the size of the plane's tiny, it's just a crap. Two and two. And one island in the middle. But it's good in a way because everyone's in couples. It's very nice to be in a couple of crew.
It is a little sad as well, being the last flight. This airplane was built to fly to New York after all. And if this airplane, this marvellous machine, could cry, I'm sure it'd be doing it now. I'll see you on board.
Sun is setting in London, and we'll be taking off in the dark. We'll arrive in New York, the sun will be back up again. We will have caught it.
Did it flash?
No, I think somebody else flashed.
Did it need a flash?
That's good. All right.
Delta.
Here's a view from the boarding stairway. The gentleman let me in, and
hi. Did you want me to do pasta or
you were going to pasta? I'm okay, actually. Sorry, you put it away somewhere.
Yeah, I'd play this in my...
One more time, I'm afraid, here at the gate.
Oh, sure.
That photo comes
Thank you. Is there a
pace to this? You can go ahead if you like.
Well, I'll get to
the
picture. Yeah. Alright. Don't want to mess you up.
I'd explore the back cabin before everybody gets here.
Good idea.
I take a picture before everybody gets here.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Last trip, huh?
Yes, yeah. You're traveling with us?
Uh-huh.
Oh,
where's the bathroom? Here?
Well, the sign,
I think I'll take a picture of that before it gets busy. Pretty much a regular bathroom, huh?
Yes, had the Concorde be going on, we had new bathrooms all ready to go to be fitted in here. These are the old bathrooms.
Oh, so I hear people have been stealing the toilet seats?
Well, they've been stealing anything that's not bolted down.
Huh.
But the toilet seat is
bolted
down.
That's good. I don't know where you'd want a toilet
seat. It's Concorde, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
with some stars and vibes and then orange and new black.
Nearly.
Almost.
Nearly.
When that was so young. I kind of feel out of place.
Oh, that's, yeah. I think maybe if you had gone 6 months ago, you would have found that the crowd was a little older.
Really?
Taking off towards the east, that's towards London. It's quite a long taxi to the takeoff point. Taking off towards London and then turn right to Stinsbury Airport to try and not make too much noise over London City itself. Then we head for Bristol. Halfway down the Bristol Channel we go supersonic. Weather in New York is fine, although a little chilly. It's 6 degrees at the moment. Next few days it's going to go up to about 20 degrees, but at the moment it's really 6 degrees. There's a bit of a brisk wind from the northwest, but it's not forecast to rain or anything. As we push out, you'll probably see various trucks. They're going to provide some sort of rainbow hose effect that we have to taxi through for the cameras. There is a lot of media interest in this departure. So as we're airborne, if you look out the window, you'll probably see thousands of people, TV cameras, all sorts of things, lots of flashcards going on as well. So I'll leave in the capable hands of my cabin crew, let them know my cabin service director, I'm sure they will look after you extremely well. Just two more things to add. Very good idea to pay attention to the safety briefing that the cabin crew is about to give you. Good idea to keep your seatbelts fastened when you try to fly as well. I'll speak to you later.
And our
tonight, so we're going to make this a very wonderful flight for you and for us.
very sad. Most of us have been on the aircraft for a very large number of years, some over 20 years. So any questions you've got, you fire away. We've got certificates for you that are already will already be signed by the captain. And in the seat pocket in front of you, you'll find our Shopping the World brochure. It's the Concorde collection. It's everything on board about Concorde, all the duty-free. And I'd like you to buy as much as you can because we want to break the record. At the moment, it's £16,000. And I know that as this is the last flight, everything you buy will be more than just a collector's item because of the fact it is the last 01. Let's try and break that record. Get it into the newspapers. Your little receipt will have the date on it, so it will be worth a lot of money. That's later on in the flight, I'll go through that. And we've also got a lot of European speaking passengers. So your cabin crew tonight speak French, Spanish, Italian and German. Mesdames et messieurs, bonsoir. Bienvenue à bord de ce Concorde. Et la durée du vol sera 3h29. Señoras y señores, buenas tardes. Bienvenidos a bordo de Concorde. La duración del vuelo será 3 horas 29 minutos. Signore e signori, buonasera, benvenuti a bordo di Concorde e la durata del volo sarà di circa 3 ore e 29 minuti.
Maybe behind you.
To help you find your way to the exit, additional lighting will be provided in the aisles and floor level. If you have liked the event, come to you for the table side, please leave all your hand baggage behind, and ladies remove high heel shoes as they could tear the path. Please now ensure that your table is folded away, the seat back is upright with the armrest down, and just be starting to secure the path. Whenever the bus is seen outside the door, you must return to the seat and fasten your belt securely. If the cabin air supply fails, oxygen will be provided. Masks like this will appear automatically. Then you need and wait for your mask to warm you. This will open your oxygen supply. Place the mask over your mouth and nose like this and breathe normally. Adjust your very shortly now. So I'm going to dim the cabin lights, just for safety reasons, and also you'll get a fabulous view. You'll see the water jets, hopefully, as we go under them. And there's quite a lot of people waiting to watch us take off. So sit back, relax, and enjoy a wonderful takeoff with us.
chocolates.
What is it, a man?
Chocolate, no, there's two, I think, in there.
Is it?
It says on the back, three. Yeah.
Thank you.
Airways speaking, attention cabin crew, with approximately 20 minutes to land.
Bumpy ride down today. Very fast descent.
Beautiful ride.
Ladies and gentlemen, first officer, we have been warned by air traffic control that it might be a little bit bumpy from here on in.
Well, we finally punched through the clouds. Looks like we're about, well, I'll have to look at the altimeter. 5,500 feet, it says. The ocean. Thank you.
reverse.
And we're just coming out with the other little gifts for you now. So just, we haven't stopped yet, we are just slowly taxiing in. There's quite a few people here to meet us. And as I said, it's just been an absolute pleasure. I know the cabin crew are going to be very, very upset later. I'm sure you will be too. This is such a beautiful aircraft. We're all very sad to lose her. Anyway, we've all shared today. And very safe, pleasant on my journey. We look forward to seeing you in first class or somewhere incredibly sumptuous a little later on. Bye-bye for now.
Cross check now, please.
doors are now manual and cross check.
On there we've got a BBC radio reporter, television reporter, and a print reporter.
This is the final chapter in the Concorde story here. Picking up the luggage.